Granville Penn, Wikipedia Audio. Granville Penn was a great-grandson of Admiral Sir William Penn, a British author, and scriptural geologist. He was born December 9, 1761 in Spring Gardens, London, the second surviving son of Thomas Penn and his wife, Lady Juliana Fermor Penn, fourth daughter of Thomas, 1st Earl of Pomfret. He studied at Magdalen College, Oxford, but did not complete his degree. He then became an assistant clerk in the War Department. In the period from 1788, Penn played a part in the development of veterinary education. A supporter of the Odiham Society, he met Charles Benoit Viel de Sainville, who was in England for the second time to try to set up a veterinary school, such as existed at Lyon, and whose profile was raised when he was asked to dissect the famous racehorse eclipse. Penn ran a successful campaign over a few years to implement his own version of Sainville's original scheme. The Veterinary College, London, opened its doors to pupils at the beginning of 1792. Biography. In 1834, Penn succeeded his brother, John Penn, in the estates of Stoke Park, Buckinghamshire, and Pennsylvania Castle, Portland. He died at Stoke Park on September 28, 1844. He had married Isabella, the eldest daughter of General Gordon Forbes, and had four sons and five daughters. Penn, fluent in French, Greek, Latin and Hebrew, was a fellow of the Society of Antiquaries and wrote several books dealing with biblical criticism and published a number of competent translations of ancient Greek works, including a critical revision of the English version of the New Testament. He also wrote some theological works particularly related to biblical chronology and the early history of post-flood mankind. In 1833 he wrote The Life of Admiral Sir William Penn, on his great-grandfather. His major work as a scriptural geologist was A Comparative Estimate of the Mineral and Mesocycle Geologies, published in 1822. Penn added a supplement in 1823 in response to Buckland's theory on Kirkdale Cave, and then revised and enlarged it to two volumes in 1825 in response to criticisms. Like most scriptural geologists, Penn only briefly delved into the topic during his career. For example, between the production of his book when he was 62 and his death in 1844, he focused on philological scholarship. To protest what he considered to be jaundiced slander on his position concerning biblical and scientific authority, Penn used the Galileo example of reasonable inquiry contrasted against clerical dogmatism. In the context of the early 1820s debate, his point was serious and justified. The image of science struggling against bigotry, also used by Lyell and Buckland, proved useful on both sides of the cosmological divide to claim the moral high ground. Penn wrote that the science of geology has this remarkable character above all the preceding physical sciences, that it not only conducts the intelligence, like them, to the discernment of the God of nature, but advances it further, to a distinct recognition of that God of nature in the God of Scripture. Penn thought correct understanding of Genesis was, 1. Genesis is historical, and 2. It used phenomenological language. He stated the effects of creation optically, or, as they would have appeared to the eye, and devoid of assignment of physical causes. He believed that the creative acts came before the laws of nature, which were then set in operation. And, the days of Genesis 1 were literal, rotations of the planet. The Book of the New Covenant. A Review and New Translation, 1836. Writings. A Comparative Estimate. Attitude Toward Geology. Works. Notes.